The skin is the body's largest organ. Without our skin, we cannot survive. Let's take a closer look into the skin. We go through the epidermis into the underlying dermis and the subcutaneous tissue. We see a cross-section of the skin. The epidermis, the upper layer of the skin, and the dermis, the lower layer, must be tightly attached to each other. This is secured in the basement membrane zone, the white line, which functions as double adhesive tape to glue the skin layers together. In most types of epidermolysis bullosa, the basal cells, which form the lowest cell layer in the epidermis, are the most important cells. Let's take a closer look. In reality, the cells are attached to each other. Each cell has a skin of its own, the cell membrane, which holds a jelly-like substance called cytoplasm. The cytoplasm contains all the structures that are important to the cell. Next, we travel into the cell, where we see the nucleus, in purple. The nucleus is the command center of the cell. It contains the genetic material of the cell, our DNA. Each cell contains the same DNA in its nucleus. The DNA dictates what the cells should be doing and how. The DNA can be divided into pieces that each have specific functions. These pieces are called genes. Genes can be seen as recipes for proteins that have all sorts of functions in our body. There are genes that determine the color of our eyes or determine how tall we will grow, but we also have genes that control the production of the anchoring proteins that should attach our epidermis to the dermis. In order to do so, the DNA first needs to be copied, a process called transcription. The DNA copy is called messenger RNA, visualized by the blue stretch. After several modifications, the messenger RNA is transported out of the nucleus, where it will function as a template for the production of protein. The translation of messenger RNA into protein takes place on structures called ribosomes, here in orange balls. Some proteins have functions inside the cells. In this example, the protein formed is keratin. Many keratin molecules subsequently assemble into a keratin network, which forms a skeleton inside the skin cells that provides the cells with their required strength. Other proteins have functions outside the cells. After translational ribosomes, they are wrapped into little packages, called vesicles, and transported towards the cell membrane. Upon fusion with the cell membrane, the vesicle contents are released into the extracellular space. Outside the cells, anchoring molecules assemble into anchoring structures, which perform the function of the double adhesive tape, here shown in green, at the basement membrane zone. To summarize, healthy DNA, healthy RNA, healthy protein, healthy cell skeleton and double adhesive tape, and healthy skin. In genetic diseases, there is usually one gene that is at fault. There is an error called a mutation, in red, in the DNA that impairs or even completely abolishes its function. The mutation is first copied into the messenger RNA. The mutated messenger RNA cannot be translated into normal protein. Some mutations lead to the formation of an abnormal protein, like in most simplex forms of epidermolysis bullosa. There's a less stable keratin skeleton and easier blister formation. Other mutations lead to the production of less protein or no protein at all. For instance, this is the case in most forms of junctional epidermolysis bullosa and severe generalized recessive dystrophic epidermolysis bullosa. The double adhesive tape proteins are reduced or even absent in the basement membrane zone. causing severe blistering after the slightest friction. Like in the skin of Dennis Parlevliet.